optical, cellular communication systems and GSM. Welcome to Improve Your Knowledge. Microwaves are generally described as electromagnetic waves with frequencies that range from approximately 300 MHz to 300 GHz or more. There are many different types of microwave systems operating over distances that vary from 15 miles to 4,000 miles in length. Intrastate or feeder service microwave systems are generally categorized as short-haul because they are used to carry information for relatively short distances, such as between cities within the same state. Long-haul microwave systems are those used to carry information for relatively long distances, such as interstate and backbone route applications. Microwave communications. Microwave repeaters. 3. A microwave repeater is a receiver and a transmitter placed back-to-back or in tandem with the system. The repeater station receives a signal, amplifies and reshapes it, and then retransmits the signal to the next repeater or terminal station downline from it. Basically, there are three types of microwave repeaters: IF, baseband, and RF. Microwave communications. Advantages of microwave radio. Radio systems do not require a right-of-way acquisition between stations. Each station requires the purchase or lease of only a small area of land. Because of their high operating frequencies, microwave radio systems can carry large quantities of information. High frequencies mean short wavelengths, which require relatively small antennas. Radio signals are more easily propagated around physical obstacles such as water and high mountains. Fewer repeaters are necessary for amplification. Distances between switching centers are less. Underground facilities are minimized. Minimum delay times are introduced. Minimal crosstalk exists between voice channels. Increased reliability and less maintenance are important factors. Disadvantages of microwave radio. It is more difficult to analyze and design circuits at microwave frequencies. Measuring techniques are more difficult to perfect and implement at microwave frequencies. It is difficult to implement conventional circuit components, resistors, capacitors, inductors, and so on, at microwave frequencies. Transient time is more critical at microwave frequencies. It is often necessary to use specialized components for microwave frequencies. Microwave frequencies propagate in a straight line, which limits their use to line of sight applications. 5. Microwave communications. 6. Frequency modulated microwave radio system. 7. Communication between the base station and mobiles is defined by the Standard Common Air Interface, CAI, frequency division duplexing uses two radio channel. Forward channel, base station to mobile user. Reverse channel, mobile user to base station. Forward voice channel, FVC voice transmission from base station to mobile. Reverse voice channel, RVC voice transmission from mobile to base station. Forward control channels, FCC initiating mobile call from base station to mobile. Reverse control channel, RCC initiating mobile call from mobile to base station. 8. Cellular systems basic concepts. Cellular system solves the problem of spectral congestion. Offers high capacity in limited spectrum. High capacity is achieved by limiting the coverage area of each BS to a small geographical area called cell. Replaces high-powered transmitter with several low-power transmitters. Each BS is allocated a portion of total channels and nearby cells are allocated completely different channels. All available channels are allocated to small NO of neighboring BS. Interference between neighboring BSs is minimized by allocating different channels. 9. Cellular system / network. 10. Frequency reuse. The design process of selecting and allocating channel groups for all the cellular base stations within a system is called frequency reuse or frequency planning. Frequency reuse distance, minimum distance B/W cochannel cells required to keep cochannel interference below certain threshold. Each cellular base station is allocated a group of radio channels to be used within. A small geographic area. Called cell. Base station of adjacent cell serine channel group. Which contains completely different channels than neighboring cells. If n cells which collectively use the complete set of available frequencies is called a cluster. 11. Frequency reuse. Frequency reuse. Cell geometry. Frequency reuse. Hexagonal cell shape is conceptual and is a simplistic model of radio coverage for each base station. As the radiation from antenna is circular, thus there is fading on the edges of triangle and square. But in hexagon shape, there is lesser fading on the edges. When using hexagonal shaped cell, base station areas are depicted as either being in center of cell, i.e. central excited cell, or on the three edges of the six cell vertices, i.e. edge excited cell. 13. 14. For central excited cell, omnidirectional antennas are used. For edge excited cell, sectored directional antennas are used. Frequency reuse. Frequency reuse. The base station antennas are designed to achieve the desired coverage within the particular cell. By limiting the coverage of a cell, the same group of channels may be used to cover different cells that are separated from one another by large distances enough to keep interference level within tolerable limit. After how many cells two cells assign the same frequency to use, frequency reuse concepts is used. Consider a cellular system which has a total of s duplex channels, total no of channels in a cluster. If each cell is allocated a group of k channels and if s channels are divided among n cells into unique and disjoint channel groups. Total number of available radio channels in a cluster can be given as s equals kn. If a cluster is replicated m times within a system, total number of duplex channel C can be used as a measure of capacity and is given as C equals MS. C equals MKN. Capacity of a cellular system is directly proportional to number of times a cluster is replicated in a fixed service area. Frequency reuse. Factor N called cluster size. Let total number of channel allocated for a cluster is M equals 395. Let n equals 7, n equals number of cells in a cluster, it means 395/7 equals 57 frequencies is possible an average per cell to characterizing the frequency reuse. Frequency reuse factor of a cellular system is equals 1/n, since each cell within a cluster is only assigned 1/n of total available channels in the system. N equals cluster size is given by n equals i2 plus j2 plus i dot j. I and j are integers. For I equals 1, j equals 1, then n equals 3. I.e. one cluster has 3 cells. N maybe equals 1, 3, 4, 7, 9, 12, 13, 16, 19 etc. 16. 17. D equals distance B/W center of two adjacent cells, R equals radius of cell. D equals minimum distance B/W center of cells that use same channels or frequency band, co-channels. Frequency reuse distance, D2 equals 3R2, I2 plus J2 plus I dot J. D2 equals 3R2 dot N. D equals, 3N, 1/2. R or D/R equals, 3N, 1/2. As D equals 31/2 dot R. D slash D equals, N, 1/2. Frequency reuse. Locating cochannel cell. 3. 18 To find the nearest cochannel neighbors of a particular cell, one must do the following. A. Move I cells along any chain of hexagon. B. Turn 60° counterclockwise and move J cells. Channel assignment strategies, CA, frequency reuse scheme. Increases capacity. Minimize interference. 19. 20. Fixed channel assignment. Each cell is allocated a predetermined set of voice channel. Any new call attempt can only be served by the unused channels. The call will be blocked if all channels in that cell are occupied. Dynamic channel assignment. Channels are not allocated to cells permanently. Allocate channels based on request. Reduce the likelihood of blocking, increase capacity. Handoff. Handoff. When a mobile moves into a different cell while conversation is in progress, the MSC automatically transfers the call to a new channel belonging to new base station is known as handoff. Handoff operation not only involves identifying a new base station, but also requires that the voice and control signals be allocated to channels with the new base station. Handoff must be performed successfully and as infrequently as possible. For this, system designer must specify an optimum signal level at which to initiate a handoff. Once a particular signal level is specified as the minimum usable signal for acceptable voice quality at the base station receiver, a slightly stronger signal level is used as a threshold at which a handoff is made. This margin, threshold, is given by delta equals PR, handoff, PR, min usable. Classification of handoff. Handoff can be classified as 1. Hard handoff. 2. Soft handoff. 1. Hard handoff. Also known as break before make. It is one in which the channel in the source cell is released and only then the channel in the target cell is engaged. Thus the connection to the source is broken before the connection to the target is made. Hard handoffs are intended to be instantaneous in order to minimize the disruption to the call. It is not necessary that there is always a connection B/W base station and mobile station. 22. Classification of handoff. 2. Soft handoff. Also known as make before break. It is one in which the channel in the source cell is retained and used for a while in parallel with the channel in target cell. Thus the connection to the target is established before the connection to the source is broken. In this kind of handoff, there is always a connection B/W base station and mobile station. 23. GSM F11_5 Global System for Mobile, GSM. GSM System Architecture, NSS. Handles the switching of GSM calls between external networks and the BSCs in the radio subsystem. Responsible for managing and providing external access to several customer databases. The MSC is the central unit in the NSS and controls the traffic among all of the BSCs. NSS contains three different databases. Home Location Register, HLR. Visitor Location Register, VLR. Authentication Center, AUC. Global System for Mobile, GSM. GSM System Architecture. Home Location Register, contains subscriber information and location information for each user who resides in the same city as the MSC. International Mobile Subscriber Identity, IMSI, is used to identify the home user. Visiting Location Register, temporarily stores the IMSI and customer information for each roaming subscriber who is visiting the coverage area of a particular MSC. If a roaming mobile is logged in the VLR, the MSC sends the necessary information to the visiting subscriber's HLR, so that calls to the roaming mobile can be appropriately routed over the PSTN by the roaming user's HLR. Global System for Mobile, GSM. GSM System Architecture. Authentication Center, a strongly protected database which handles the authentication and encryption keys for every single subscriber in the HLR and VLR. AUC has Equipment Identity Register, EIR. EIR identifies stolen or fraudulently altered phones whose identities are not there in VLR or HLR. Global System for Mobile, GSM. GSM System Architecture. Operation Support Subsystem, supports one or several Operation Maintenance Centers, OMC. OMC used to monitor and maintain the performance of each MS, BS, BSC, and MSC within a GSM system. The OSS has three main functions. Maintain all telecommunications hardware and network operation. Manage all charging and billing procedures. Manage all mobile equipment in the system. GSM. F11_6. ABI's interface connects a BTS to BSC, carries traffic and maintenance data. Specified by GSM. A interface, interface between a BSC and a MSC, dedicated leased lines or microwave link. SS7, network message communication between the MSC, the BSS, and MSS. UMTS. 30 UMTS differs from GSM Phase 2+, GSM and GPRS, mostly in the new principles for the air interface transmission UGMA instead of TDMA/FDMA. Therefore a new RAN, Radio Access Network, called UTRAN, UMTS Terrestrial Radio Access Network, must be introduced with UMTS. Only minor modifications are needed in the CN, core network, to accommodate the change. UTRA, UMTS Terrestrial Radio Access. 31. The most significant change in REL 99 was the UTRAN, a WCDMA radio interface for land-based communications. UTRAN supports time, TDD, and frequency division duplex, FDD. The TDD mode is optimized for public micro and pico cells and unlicensed cordless applications. The FDD mode is optimized for wide area coverage, i.e. public macro and micro cells. Both modes offer flexible and dynamic data rates up to 2 Mbps. UMTS architecture. 32 UTRAN, UTRA network, radio network subsystem, RNS. UE, user equipment, CN, core network, UU. IU. CN. UTRAN UE. UMTS architecture UTRAN. 33 Two new network elements are introduced in UTRAN RNC. Node B. UTRAN is subdivided into individual radio network systems, RNSs, where each RNS is controlled by an RNC. The RNC is connected to a set of Node B elements, each of which can serve one or several cells. UMTS architecture, UTRAN architecture. UTRAN comprises several RNSs. Node B can support FDD or TDD or both. RNC is responsible for handover decisions requiring signaling to the UE. Cell offers FDD or TDD. RNC, radio network controller. RNS, radio network subsystem. Node B. Node B. RNC IUB Node B. UE1. RNS. CN. Node B. Node B. RNC IUB Node B. RNS. IR. Node B. UE2. UE3. IU. UTRAN functions. Admission control. Congestion control. Radio channel encryption. Handover. Radio network configuration. Channel quality measurements. Radio resource control. Data transmission over the radio interface. Outer loop power control, FDD and TDD. Channel coding. 35. Core network. BTS. Node B. BSC. ABI's BTS. BSS MSC. Node B. Node B. RNC. IUB. Node B RNS. Node B SGSN. GGSN. GMSC. HLR. VLR. IUPS. IUCS. IUCN. EIR. GN. GI. PSTN. AUC. GR. The core network, CN, and the interface IU, are separated into two logical domains, circuit switch domain, CSD. Circuit switch service including signaling. Resource reservation at connection setup. GSM components, MSC, GMSC, VLR. IUCS. Packet switch domain, PSD. GPRS components, SGSN, GGSN. IUPS. Like, subscribe, share. Like, subscribe, share. Thank you.